We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Commodores and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing
it. Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
It's second and four to go. Ball on their own 31.
Three down.
Mike check, 33.
He's to the 40. Brought down at the 47-yard line.
That's not everyday speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision.
Steps out at the 48-yard line, a 5-yard gain.
Not a bad play. They gain 5 yards out of it, and they keep moving the defense back.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Gets to about the 47-yard line. Really one of the very tough places to play in college football, and it's no different today. Quick throw, and down he goes, around the 36-yard line.
Here's the true test of a quarterback at any level. Can they make a good throw under pressure when one or two or three guys are coming right at him? I think this young passer has proven that, yes, he can.
Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? Drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
And they got it.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
This is the 8th play of this drive. And this crowd is going absolutely crazy. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. And he's got to be happy with that punt, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, that was nice. Now they're looking at a long way to go to even think about a score.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. It's the tailback. He gets out to about the 17-yard line. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain.
That'll make it second and inches.
Second and inches. Ball on the 17-yard line. Gives it off. Tackle around the 19-yard line. And the tailback picks up the first down.
He's a reliable ball carrier, as he showed right there. He got the 2 yards they needed for a new set of downs.
Right back to the run game, and this time he's met immediately.
That's a loss of 4 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
Second and 13. Ball on the 15.
Mike 36. Red 2.
Caught with room to work. He's knocked out of bounds around the 32-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
From their own 32-yard line, first down.
Go four. Blue.
gets a yard on the run.
That's a nice play by the freshman corner to help out in run support.
That brings up second and nine.
Think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He showed some excellent moves out there, more than you usually expect from a tight end. That was a big gain, and this offense keeps humming along. It's first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line.
Mike 36. Mike 36.
Here we go here. Kill, kill, kill.
And he's sacked.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive.
Watch 36. 36 to Mike.
Green 9, green 9.
Pulls it in and he's in the open field. Tackle made at the 40.
Number 22 makes the set goal at the 40-yard line.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. He's going to try and scramble, and he's tackled around the 38-yard line.
This is a good call by the defensive coordinator. He guessed run, and when the offense came with it, his guys were in position to make the stop.
Here we go, here we go, here we go. To the next seven. To the next, go.
Run, 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 run.
They'll bring him down at the 36. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36.
Watch 36. 36.
Red 2. Blue 20. Go.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal. Play of the drive coming up. Nice run there.
That brings him second and goal.
So at the end of one quarter, now this one's scoreless. We're all tied up and more action coming, hopefully, here in quarter number 2.
Watch 36. 36 to Mike.
Dog 4.
Run, 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 run.
He's tackled around the 4-yard line.
Oh, call it a gain of 1 yard. That makes it.
So here we go. It's third and goal from the 4, and this would break the tie.
Four down, four down. Mike, 36. Mike,
go, 4. Go.
Going to the end zone. Touchdown for the tight end. Converts the extra point. A long 15-play, 93-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Good job, D. Good job.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Play action. And they make the stop at the 45. First and 10. Ball on their own 45.
Let's go!
He makes it to the 45-yard line. And he manages to get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Hit out of bounds around the 49-yard line.
Number 24, the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and six.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Really a tough spot for an offense to be in against this crowd in this stadium.
Black and five. Black and five.
Motion.
And they'll run him again. They'll knock him down for a loss.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
Too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Alabama is up by a touchdown. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. Makes it out to about the 33. Now he's scrambling. And he tucked that one in for about 5 yards. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Mike 36. Mike 36. Green 9. Green.
He goes out of bounds around the 40-yard line.
Not that impressive of a play. Let's see if they continue to employ the short passing game or if they decide to run the ball.
Gets out to about the 42-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. Fourth down.
He puts it away, and it's a great kick. Tackle made at the 22. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. Vanderbilt's going to use their first time out of the half here. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Caught, and this is going to be a first down. He's taken down right around the 40.
Number 24 on the tackle at the 40-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Caught. Open field.
And he is drilled at the 49-yard line.
Gain of 11 on the play. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 49. He's got it out to his tight end.
Well-designed route and a confidently thrown football by the quarterback. You need those things to make any offense work.
Catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Call it a gain of 13 yards.
First and 10. Ball on the 32. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Complete. He's got room. And he's taken down around the 17-yard line.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
They'll get him for a loss.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really, there's nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
False start offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
It's up, and it sails through the uprights. Vanderbilt ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Alabama is up four. He gets out to about the 37-yard line.
Sometimes when you've got speed, that's all you need. It's the one thing you just can't defend.
From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. And this one falls incomplete. Probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. Pressure coming. He goes downtown. No, incomplete. It's halftime, and we've got a close one. 7-3, Crimson Tide.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers. but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad, Kirk, take the second half.
Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Alabama is up by four. On the ground with the tailback. He makes it to the 28-yard line. From their own 28-yard line, second down.
I love the toughness here by this quarterback of sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit. At least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
And down he goes, right around the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line, first down. Defensive end came through to put him away.
Nice job of utilizing his athletic ability to get in there and then make a sure tackle.
So we're looking at another third down here. Brought down at the 45-yard line. Holds a 4-point lead.
Red two. Set. Ooh, set. 20. Set.
Decent run here, right side.
That's a D5 on the play. That brings him second and five.
From the 40-yard line. Second down.
Mike 36. Mike 36. Red two.
Set.
Green eight.
Nice run up the middle.
With the run, gaining 4 yards. That'll make it third and one.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive.
Tight end right. Go down. Watch 36. 36 to Mike.
Red two.
Tackle around the 35-yard line. From the 35-yard line. First down. Carries the ball for a nice game. It's the 11th play of the drive. He gets rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Another third down upcoming, and they've converted all three this drive.
Orange three, go!
Goes a laser across the middle. Tackle made at the 26. That's a deal.
Man left. Go down. Watch 36.
On the throw, incomplete. big stop by the defense. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Throws it and oh, he dropped it.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception only to be dropped.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 26. And he's tackled at the 23. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up five wide. And they got him.
He has one job on passing situations. Get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
So no luck on that drive as they go three and out. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. He really got a hold of that one. Pretty good job by the return man there. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Alabama is up four. They'll bring him down at about the 49. Second and nine. Ball on the 49-yard line.
Red, two, go!
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. How about the play of this defensive end?
This is just solid run defense here. They get a great push up front, not allowing the runner to have much room to work with. And at the end, they're able to wrap him up.
Mike, 36. Mike, 36. Red, two, green, go!
And he shoved out of bounds right around the 48-yard line.
Well, the defense has done their job and made a nice stand. Now let's see if the special teams can come up with something here as well.
And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's got an opening. And he's tackled at the 46.
Gain of 34 on the play. First down.
Looking to capitalize on the big run. Now it's first and 10.
Let's go, tight end. Let's go right here now. Mic check, 33.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's tackled at the 41-yard line.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That brings up second and 5.
So at the end of the third quarter, the Crimson Tide in front, 7-3. Great three quarters of action, tight ball game, and now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it.
Quarterback, don't get nervous now. We ain't beginning.
Let's go!
He might have a chance. Makes it to the 31.
First and 10.
From the 31-yard line, it's first down.
Let's go! High five!
They bring the quarterback down.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
make the stop at the 30.
Number 13 makes the tackle at the 30-yard line.
Third and long here with a vital drive in the fourth quarter, and they need a conversion. It's arguably the loudest crowd in the nation, and they are turning it up a notch. Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen, and he tackles him hard at the 25-yard line. Taken down at the 21.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards.
This is the eighth play of this drive.
Tight right, tight right.
Three down, three down.
Three down, three down.
Mark, run, 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 run.
Inside the 10. Touchdown, and they take the lead.
He is such a talented, skillful back, as you saw right there. What makes him even better is that these coaches know how to use him.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. Vanderbilt kicked this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And they can forget about returning this one. 4 yards have been tough to come by for both these teams.
But it's been ugly to watch. The only thing you can really say is at least it's competitive still in the fourth quarter.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. That's a great tackle at the 28.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
It's second and seven. Ball on the 28.
Mike, 36.
Red two.
Mike, seven.
Go.
Six.
Go.
And he hits him hard at the 20-yard line.
That's a loss of 8 yards. That makes it third and 15.
Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
False start. Offense.
They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're still in third a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Third down and very long, and behind in this ball game in the fourth quarter. They've got to have this one. And he's going to be sacked. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
And that'll be three and out.
Get out, get out, get out. Let's go, hurry up, on the ball, on the ball.
Just under three to go in regulation. Booming kick. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. Well, if you like defensive football, you got to love this one.
Now, neither one of these offenses have gotten really into a rhythm the entire ball game. Still the fourth quarter to be played. It's anybody's game.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
From the 36-yard line, it's second down. Now he tries to buy some time. And he's taken down around the 25-yard line.
Well, this is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
Alabama is going to use their first time out of the half here. Hauls it in as he's pushed. pushed out of bounds.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play action. The halfback just couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Loss of one. They're at the three. It's second down. Toss out to the halfback, and he's stuffed immediately. One of the top stadiums in the nation. This crowd comes to play themselves. Field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Just over a minute left. He gets it up, and the field goal is good. Vanderbilt is ready to kick it away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership. And he is drilled at the 20.
That's a loss of 5 yards. That'll bring up second and 15.
Spikes the ball. Biggest third down and long of the football game right here in the fourth quarter. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. This is their last chance. They need a big play here. Throws it deep. Got him. And down he goes. Right around the 32-yard line. Stops the clock with a spike.
That makes it second and 10.
Second and 10. Ball on the 32.
Four down. Mike 36. Red.
Back. Quick throw to the back. It's incomplete. Under a minute left. Be able to get the pass off. And he's level at the 18.
Kill.
First down.
Here we go. Blue 20. Go.
The spike will stop the clock.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 18.
Mike 36. Red 2.
Makes the grab and steps out right away. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
10th play of the drive. Caught for the touchdown, and we are all tied up.
Thank you.
scores the extra point that can give them the lead. The offense didn't get the playoff
delayed
in time.
Delayed game. Offense.
Under a minute left in the game. And he hits the PAT. Alabama gets set to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Commodores have sort of set up the defense with this wide receiver doing most of the damage. Do they go away from him or do they do something different?
I think one of two things here for this offense. You either find a way to get your star receiver the football, or in some cases you want to use him as a decoy, maybe take two or three defenders with him, and then open it up for somebody else to be able to make a play.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's pushed out of bounds around the 50-yard line.
He adds a whole other dimension when he's on the field. He took that short pass and turned it into a huge gain, all because of his blazing speed.
From the 50, first down.
Check, 24, 24, check, 24. Hey, check, check.
Ready, blue and hot.
And he just gets rid of it. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Offense lines up in a five wide set, and a defense anticipating pass here. Gets it out to his receiver, and he can't hang on. This will be it. If he misses, they'll wonder about what could have been. If he makes it, he'll be a school hero for years to come. The kick is away, and he nails the long field goal. Here, a touchdown return is their only chance at victory. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. Well, this is the chance. Late in the fourth quarter, they're behind, but they've got an opportunity now to come back and win it. So this is it right here. One last play and one last chance to win the game. If they can get the Hail Mary, they'll pull out the miracle win. And that one's incomplete. Final score lower than we expected. 16-14, Commodore. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Street, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.